January 12th, 2010, it's the day that changed Haiti forever.
Buildings had fallen down, homes had collapsed, most of the time on people.
In less than a minute, 250,000 to 300,000 people died.
Then more than 1.5 million homeless.
After the earthquake, the situation was very dramatic.
There was a lack of food, a lack of water.
There was no transportation.
People were everywhere on the street.
There was no electricity that was functioning.
It was a terrible event for most Haitians who experienced the earthquake.
It was like victims helping victims.
The entire nation was affected, and an entire nation will never be the same.
It was really a nightmare.
HA313 is one of our church partners. They are a Wesleyan church in Carfoufei who was hit very hard by the earthquake.
This is one of the projects where we would take visitors because of the quality of the program.
Every person here lost loved ones.
All the buildings have been collapsed.
The school fell down. They had nowhere to send their children.
I'll never forget driving through this section. We were following loaders and heavy equipment as they plowed through the debris. To see that beautiful church building standing there with the front of it all fractured and broken into pieces, and then to come up here and find the school laying in rubble.
Compassion's been in Haiti for 50 years, so we had staff on the ground after the earthquake. By noon the next day, our country director had arrived to the office.
I called my staff members, and then they showed up at the office. We start putting together our efforts to go to the churches and then help the beneficiaries.
Compassion pursued a three-part strategy. We needed to provide immediate relief to our church partners.
There was the first phase of relief, which was basically the idea of survival, getting those children from the rubble, getting them to medical clinic, giving them food, and getting their families civilized.
We're not a relief organization. That's not what we do. We do child development. But the crisis was so great, we needed to respond immediately to those partners who were in desperate need.
We provided temporary shelters for people. We provided food, water.
We started pursuing a census where we could count our children to locate and find out where they were and if they were okay.
We also provided the transitional shelters for the projects themselves so that they could continue working.
Compassion also distributed tents and wood, nails, and even iron sheets in some areas for people to build up a shelter for their families who had lost their houses.
We provided financial assistance to our church partners.
Compassion didn't only assist the children, they also extend their help to the people who worked with the children. They have had helping programs to economically support pastors, project directors, monitors, and staff who were victims of the earthquake.
We started post-traumatic counseling for our project staff, for our children, and for our Compassion staff as well.
Due to the generosity of our dear sponsors and donors, they collect more than 30 million.
A total of 30.4 million was raised.
About half of that money was spent on short-term relief and transitional relief, the medium-term things. The other half has been and is being spent on the long-term efforts.
We have four things that we consider as long-term.
One of the long-term strategies we're pursuing is a pastor encouragement and vision casting strategy.
We need to challenge the pastors, we need to challenge the churches to raise their voice, their prophetic voice.
We have to come to the point where we are equipping people to take their lives in their hands, and then they make the proper decisions for themselves and change their circumstances.
Another of our strategies is a child protection strategy where we sought out those children who were highly vulnerable children within our Compassion family, those children who became orphans, who became handicapped because of the earthquake, and were particularly susceptible to being exploited. We started a strategy where we could reach into their lives, find them places to live, protect them in a way that may need to go beyond what we do normally with children. Another of our long-term strategies is our income generation program, where we provide entrepreneurial training and microfinance loans to entrepreneurs who are parents of our children.
We want to provide possibility to the parents to be able to get income and then to create jobs. Also, we have the reconstruction. It is the biggest program now we have as a long term.
So we have a reconstruction program where we're going in to build these projects, build these schools at 30 of our church partners. We are determined to build these buildings safely. We are meeting international seismic standards so that the next time there's an earthquake, these buildings don't fall down on our children.
Building anything in Haiti requires planning, execution, and time.
There's nothing easy here. Finding materials for construction that meet our standards was difficult. Finding qualified people was difficult. Training the workers for a new way to build was difficult.
In order to build to international standards, you must have people that know what those standards are.
What do we even turn to actually find the right people?
Our designs had to come from El Salvador.
We've had to bring people from either the U.S. or from El Salvador or other countries to help provide that technical expertise. 313 is the model for not only the type of program that we have, the type of partnership that we have, but also as a symbol of what we want to do for the country in the future.
Compassion built for us these two new buildings. They guarantee us a different place in terms of beauty, quality, and safety compared with the one we had.
The men in that community are the ones who built it with our help and our training.
This is a symbol and this is the result of the good relationship that we have been having with Compassion.
The people of this community, even if their children don't attend here, they're proud to say, there's our new school.
The whole community has been coming over to congratulate us and to promise its surveillance in order to keep this building as nice as it is. This is the nicest building we have in the community, they say.
I'm not afraid to say that it's entirely possible that our Wesleyan mission in Haiti would have collapsed during those difficult years if it weren't for our partnership with Compassion.
Now the children, they have really in peace. They feel secure and they have a better environment to learn.
The whole time we were building it, we were keeping in mind two things. The teachers who are going to be in there, who are going to transmit the education to these kids, and those children who are going to be in there that are the hope of tomorrow for a new Haiti. What we're doing in the disaster response office is temporary. In the near future, we're going to be done with our work because the earthquake response will have completed. We will have rebuilt these schools better than they were before.
We're not only putting buildings up, but I'm extremely excited by the fact that there is knowledge that is being imparted. That's what development is all about.
We can provide expertise, we can provide training, we can provide money to help teach our church partners how to build buildings correctly so the next time they won't fall down.
When I went to those building sites, and when I saw Haitian masons actually laying bricks according to code, this is a skill that they've acquired that they are going to take with them at the end of this process. And that is what we do best, and that gets me excited as well.
It's about providing opportunities for the children of Haiti to grow up, to be the leaders of Haiti, to be the godly men and women who are going to change this country forever.
Even though it has taken us long, but it is worth it, because we are investing in the people and not just erecting a building and walking away.